Should you post your staff numbers in the back break room at the salon? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to determine if you should, and if you're going to, how to do it correctly. Hey, it's Jason Everett from highperformancesalon.com, and today's video is brought to you by Meevo 2 by Millennium Systems International, the only salon and spa software customized for your world. Now, here's the thing. A lot of salon owners will come up to me and they'll say, hey, Jason, I know I'm supposed to be posting the salon numbers in the break room because I heard it's a good idea and it'll help motivate people and inspire them, but I'm worried it's gonna just bring them down and it's gonna make them feel uncomfortable. It's gonna make them feel unnecessary pressure. How do I do it? Well, first of all, if it already feels that uncomfortable for you, it's probably gonna feel that uncomfortable for them. So if you're not even comfortable with it, please don't just put the numbers up. You might create a walkout situation. I don't want that to happen inside your salon. So you gotta figure out, how does your staff actually take in and perceive numbers? I used to work for a company that when I started working there, they talked about numbers in every meeting. It was publicly aware. We would post the numbers in the back room. It'd be part of your one-on-one meeting. And it was just a normal part of the process, meaning that when I started working there, that was just how it was. I didn't even have a choice in the matter. So I couldn't resist it and leave. But if you've got a staff that has literally been there for 5, 10, 15 or more years, and they've never had to talk about numbers, and all of a sudden you post those up, people are gonna freak out. So here's one of the things that you can do to just start to introduce numbers into the scenario. Number one is make sure that you're using numbers to actually be in their one-on-one meetings where you can share with them exactly what's going on. The other thing you might wanna do is if you have a separate management room, you might want to post numbers in that management room and kind of leave them in there. The other thing you can do is start by just posting one encouraging number in the back. Like maybe during the holidays, you could post something, or you know, Mother's Day or Christmas or whatever it is, you could post something about gift card sales and start with just gently posting the number of gift card sales people are making. And it'll slowly introduce them to the idea of more and more numbers getting posted. But do it for a short window of time, take it away, put it back, add a little bit more, and slowly ease them into the process. Now, if you're just ready to rock and you're like, you know what, Jason, I think my team can handle it. We talk about numbers, we're ready to go, we're just ready to start posting them in the back. I would sit down with your key leaders inside your salon and say, hey guys, what do you think would happen if we did this? Here's what I'm thinking, how can we do it? And then actually implement it inside your salon. And if you wanna know the 5 key performance indicators that we recommend that you track, do me a favor and download our tracking sheet that'll show you the 5 specific things that you can track inside your salon to measure your overall salon's progress. So if you want that tool, then go ahead and download it on the link that will be available somewhere near this video right now. Until then, have an awesome week.